Okay, so are you able to see my screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. So it is a passive element that stores energy in its magnetic field. It is simply a coil, and in this coil, if you associate an inductance L, a coil is basically simply a, you know, what I say is actually a, if I take, for example, a cylinder and I try to wind, okay? So it's like this. So I have a cylinder like this, and in this cylinder, I am trying to wind, for example, this it. So I have a cylinder and I try to wind a coil. So you can see it's basically a CD, but you can see the wire closely wound, and it forms a kind of the such a coil. You have seen it in rheostat and in the lab, and this one solenoid. Okay, a solenoidal coil has an inductance associated with it. Okay, so there is some kind of self inductance, mutual inductance, so on and so forth. But we will just understand the basics of how an inductor works. Inductor normally does not figure in electronic circuits as much as a capacitor does. However, there are some places where an inductance is invoked. So for that matter, in a circuit, we'll try to understand the basics of the inductance, and that is what we are about it. So what in this coil, when I try to flow a current, the coil try to oppose it. The behavior of the coil is that it opposes any change in the current. It takes time for me to, when I apply voltage and try to flow a current. So this coil is wound around some kind of a core. The core could be a magnetic core like iron, or it could be a air also. So it opposes this flow of current. So that opposing property is the main thing, okay, with the inductance. Now, the relationship between the voltage that is built up across the conductor, across the inductor, and the rate of change of current is given by this relationship. So di by dt represents the rate of change of current, and the voltage that is built up across this inductor as a function of time, because the current is varying as a function of time, they are like linear relationship and related to the inductance of the coil. So V of t is equal to L di by dt. Now, what is this unit of inductance? The unit of inductance is Henry, named after the scientist Joseph Henry. And 1 Henry is the inductance of an inductor. If a voltage V of t is induced in the coil, produced by a uniform rate of change of current, 1 ampere per second. Okay. So this is my expression for the inductance in terms of, this is something that we will learn in the electromagnetic theory. For now, you can run with me and say that L equal to N square mu A by L, where mu is actually, like you have R equal to rho L by A, here also you have similar thing. L is given by the number of turns, it is square of the number of turns, and permeability of the core, mu, and core is the material that is on which the coil is wound, and A is the cross-sectional area of this core. So you can see how the core is important. So depending on the choice of the core material, the inductance is expected to vary, right? Now, as I told you, Henry is the unit after the scientist Joseph Henry. Now, there are when you see inductor, when you buy in the circuitry, you will see these kind of elements, okay? And mu is the permeability, which is mu naught. It is related to the relative permeability, just like your epsilon. Epsilon is epsilon or epsilon naught. What is that?
Sir, are you changing the slide, sir?
Yes.
But it's still in the first slide.
How many slides were you not able to see it? Maybe
from the start, it's in the first slide only, sir.
From the start itself, in the it is in the first slide, sir. It has not gone to the presentation mode, sir.
Okay, let me see that. Which slide are you seeing?
Yes, sir. Typical inductors.
Okay. Now next slide. Are you able to see it?
Yes, sir. Inductor as a circuit element.
Yes, okay. All right. Are you able to see this slide? What is that?
Inductors.
So this is what I said. Actually, the inductance is dependent on the core material, core area, area of cross section, and the number of turns in the coil, and it is actually a relationship. L is related to the voltage across the coil and the rate of change of current. It actually exhibits an opposition to the change of current. You try to flow. So typical, if you look at the automobile spark plug, it works on the principle of inductor. Okay. So definitely, moment I say inductor, you must come across the it should strike your mind with Faraday's law of inductance and Lenz law. Okay, we'll come to that. So in the circuit, you will see different types of inductors like this. You will see that just like epsilon is related to, epsilon is nothing but the permittivity of the medium. Here, that is related to relative permittivity as epsilon equal to epsilon r epsilon naught, where epsilon naught is the permittivity of free space. Here, similarly, mu is related to mu r mu naught, where mu r is the relative permeability and mu is the it is a measure of how much magnetic flux can permeate through the core. Okay, so it's a measure of that. So mu r mu naught. Okay, so we'll come to this kind of concepts in electromagnetics. Right now we will understand that the inductance is related to the core material, is actually what core material we choose and what is the number of turns, what is the area of cross section, and the length of the wire, total length of the wire. Okay, so now you can, in the circuit it is identified as this kind of element, and you can now the constant inductance, okay, and you can have a variable inductance. Okay, so these are, if you have simply this is air core. If you have something like this, it is an iron core. If you have something like this in the circuit, you will have a variable iron core. Okay, so what is the current voltage relationship? From there we'll understand more elements of this inductance. So if I take a coil, okay, a current carrying wire produces a magnetic field, and this magnetic field is related to the current, change in current I of t. So magnetic field will also change, therefore. So B is related to the change in current I of t, and you will have per unit length of the wire. So you have B of t equal to mu I by L unit length. Okay, so this we will derive this expression in the electromagnetic theory course. Right now you can just walk through. So moment you have a B coming into picture, magnetic field inductions, then there is a flux associated with this coil. The flux is given by simply the magnetic field into time, into area. So you can see, because B is changing with the time, flux will also change with the time, and you can say moment I can substitute for B, then I will get B, flux equal to A mu by L I of t, and the only parameter that is varying is the current. A is constant for a given inductor, mu is constant for a given core, a selected core, and L is also, the length of the wire is constant. So L is related to mu A L. Now you look at the same thing with resistance, you will have R equal to rho L by A, right? Rho A by L. Is it correct? What is the unit of rho? What is the unit of rho? Resistivity? Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Just a minute. Hello?
Yes, sir.
Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
What was the question I asked?
The unit of resistivity.
Yeah. Tell me. Resistivity.
Ohm meter.
Right? So,
yes, sir.
Is it ohm meter? Okay. So what is the relationship between resistivity and resistance?
Rho equal to RL by S.
Rho equal to?
R is equal to rho L by A.
R equal to rho L by A. R equal to rho L by A. Now what do you see here? L equal to? Rho is replaced by mu, permeability, right? And R equal to, what is the stuff you said? R equal to?
Rho L by A.
Rho L by A.
Rho L by A. R equal to rho L by A, correct. So which means you have similar thing here. So let us look at here. You have L equal to A mu by L, okay, capital L. Capital L is inductance. Okay, so you have to understand it is again a constant for a given coil. Now, what important point is the phi is changing. When phi is changing, because B is changing for a current varying, there will be a EMF induced. And by Faraday's law, we know that the rate of change of EMF. The rate of change of flux gives the EMF. Okay, so whenever the flux associated with the circuit changes, there is a EMF produced in the circuit. So that is what Maxwell's equation, Faraday's law of induction is about. Now you can see that EMF is actually given by d phi by dt. So I substitute for phi, I will get, because phi is varying, I will get V equal to L di by dt. This is one L of an equation you must remember. V is related to the voltage produced across the inductor, is related to the rate of change of current. Now I told you the inductor does not like the current to change. That is the opposing nature of the inductor. Okay, so remember that. So an inductor simply consists of a coil of conducting wire, and where you can see, if I were to plot the voltage produced across the inductor to rate of change of current, I will get the L. Now in resistance, we plot voltage versus I. But in inductor, we plot voltage as a rate of change of current. So this is a linear relationship. Okay. So there in a pure resistor, you have V equal to IR. Right. So analogously, if I talk about in analogous terms for an inductor, then I will have V equal to L di by dt. So the inductor is related with rate of change of current. Try to understand that. Okay. So this is a relationship. When it is linear, it is up to a certain current, it is, the flux is linear. Sometime it can be non-linear. Now the unit of flux is Weber. So L is the 1 ampere is nothing but 1 weber per unit current, 1 weber per ampere, that is the 1 Henry. Okay, so that is the relationship between the flux and the inductance. Okay, so what is this meaning of this equation? That's the most important thing. Now you see, for constant current di by dt, what will be the di by dt for constant current? It's already written here.
Zero.
And when does constant current flow through a circuit? Is it AC or DC?
DC, sir.
DC. So V will be zero. When V is zero for DC, what does that mean? Let us say I have a circuit, I have a inductor, but the current is not changing through that. It will act as a short circuit. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, if there is an abrupt change in current, okay, abrupt change means step function. Can current change? You know, for current to change abruptly, which means it is going like this, if the current changes smoothly, look at my hand. Okay, if it changes like this, it is okay. But if it changes like a step function, for that to happen, you need, which means di by dt will become, the current is infinite. Okay, so which is not really possible, practically possible. So therefore, no abrupt change of current through an inductor is possible except an infinite voltage across the inductor is supplied. That cannot happen. The inductor can be used in many applications. It can be used to generate a high voltage, used as an igniting element in spark plug, for example. Now, how does a inductor in a circuit, this thing, circuit, if you look at here, you look at the same current flows through the circuit, and here you have the, since the same current is flowing, very similar to that resistor, you will have L equal to, total L equal to L1, L2 plus L3 like that. Because I am applying a source voltage of capital V, so the total voltage will be the sum of the voltages. Now if I were to, because the same current flows through, the rate of change of current also will be the same. Therefore, di by dt will get cancelled. Therefore, you will get L1, L equal to sum of the L. So this is a series inductor. So equivalent inductance of the series connected inductors is the sum of individual inductances. The inductances in series combine in the same way as resistor in series. Now, what about parallel? In parallel, the voltages are equal across any voltage drop across any inductor, but the current is going to vary. Therefore, we will use a different way of calculating. Now, I told you, for example, if you look at this equation, if I integrate this equation, it will become L goes like 1 by L, and I will get equation like this. So I equal to 1 by L V dt. Now, the total current that is going through will be I equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3 like that. And therefore, you will get an expression like this, which will be I equal to I1 plus I2 L. And what is I? 1 by L integral V dt, and VDT integral VDT will be constant. Therefore, 1 by L equal to 1 by L1 plus 1 by L2 plus 1 by L3 L4 like that. So you will get, effectively, it is combines like resistances in parallel. Is it clear? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, what about the current voltage relationship in an inductor? Current voltage relationship in an inductor, which one actually leads or lags behind? Now, you have to understand this. Let us try to look at the current form. If the current is a time-varying current, and the expression with I of t equal to I naught cos omega t, where omega is the frequency, angular frequency given by 2 pi n. Okay, so it's a time-varying voltage. that produces a time varying current, and you have a I of t. So voltage V of t will become, if I substitute, I will get like this. So you can see that the voltage leads the current by pi by 2. Okay, so how do I understand this meaning of voltage leading the current? So you can see here graphically the voltage is leading the current. At t equal to 0, V is at 0, but when V peaks, that is when I comes to 0. So when V is peaking, that means it is no more going to change at that time. It is like the slope is becoming there is no. So let us try to understand here very simple thing. I have an inductor. I try to flow current through the inductor. It takes time for the inductor to accept the change in current. It opposes the flow of current. So I am applying a voltage ahead of the current buildup. So the voltage takes time for the current to build up in an inductor. Therefore, voltage is leading the current by a phase. Okay. The voltage across an inductor leads the current because of the opposition. The opposition comes phenomenally from the principle of Lenz's law. The Lenz's law resists the behavior of buildup of the current. It takes some time for an imposed voltage across the inductor to force the current to flow through it and to get to maximum. Is it clear? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, what about the capacitor? What did I say? Which one leads first?
Current will lead.
Because it takes time for the voltage to build up. Only when you put charge across the plates of the capacitor, the voltage builds up. So the current is the first one ahead of the voltage. So the voltage lags behind. So can you remember this concept easily?
Yes, sir.
All right. So current voltage relationship. Now I want you to think like this. So di will be equal to 1 by L VDT. So this is the voltage across the inductor built up. So I am integrating from minus infinity because I do not know what is the past story associated with that inductor. So if there had been some current at t equal to t at initial stage before I try to force the current, okay, then I will have a I of t naught. That will be the constant of integration, and therefore an inductor, you can consider it to have a memory. So when you consider a inductor, there is no ideal inductor. But our practical purposes will consider ideal inductor in our course. But there is no ideal inductor. An inductor will have a small resistance value associated with it, a capacitance value also associated with it. Okay. So it has a certain memory because at t equal to initial time, there is a current that could flow through the inductor, which we, because of the magnetic field associated with that inductor, because of the core material. Okay, so what is the energy stored? It's beautiful. In the case of a capacitance, you have half CV square. Okay, half CV square. Here, the voltage, it takes time to build up. Okay, but here, the current takes time to build up. Now, the energy stored in an inductor is actually given by half Li square, where energy with the function of time, it goes like this. So you can integrate, power is nothing but Vi, integrate from minus infinity. Minus infinity corresponds to the past history, which we do not know about the inductor. Therefore, we are integrating from minus infinity. There is no harm in doing it. And only thing is, if we understand minus infinity so far that let us assume that the inductor is built at that time, then we assume when we are building the inductor at minus infinity t equal to minus infinity, the current, we assume that it is zero, then we will get an expression at I, when I of infinity is zero, this expression diminishes to zero, effectively leaving half Li square, where I is a function of time. So that will be the energy stored in an inductor. So for a finite time, one can say, let us say I am calculating energy at t equal to 10 seconds. I might be able to understand that t equal to some 5 seconds, what is the current flowing through. But if I extend it further and further, the time when I build an inductor, at that time, I assume there is no harm in assuming I at t equal to minus infinity is zero, in which case the expression becomes, energy stored in an inductor becomes like this. So summary, V of t is nothing but a L di by dt, and it acts like a short circuit to DC. Now what about the capacitor to DC? What is the response of the capacitor to DC?
At open circuit.
It acts as a open circuit, okay? And how did you write there? I of t equal to C dv by dt. So here V of t, there I of t. Is it clear? So when V equal to zero, I is constant. This is very clear. Now, the current through an inductor cannot change instantaneously. There voltage across a capacitor cannot change instantaneously. Okay, voltage for that is not possible. Here current cannot change instantaneously. Okay, try to remember these fundamental concepts. Like the ideal capacitor, ideal inductor does not dissipate energy. In ideal capacitor, there is no leakage resistance. Okay, it holds a charge for good. Therefore, the energy is stored for good. Here also, an ideal inductor does not dissipate. But for practical purpose, if you look at a real inductor, it has a winding capacitance and a resistance of the coil also. Therefore, we can a winding resistance and a winding capacitance. The capacitance is connected in parallel across the this thing, and the winding resistance is in series with the L. Okay, because we understand the relationship in a how a capacitor behaves in a series and parallel. What is C in series? If I have n number of capacitors, what is the expression for C? 1 by C equal to 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2 plus 1 by C. Like that. But in series, right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
But in parallel, it is actually C equal to C1 plus C2. So capacitor behaves differently to electrical. It adopts a different electrical response. Inductor is more like a resistance in that sense. Okay. So in this course, we will use ideal inductors and assume. Okay. So phasor notation, if I were to look at it, Z equal to V by C, and for a pure resistor, Z equal to R, but there is a phase. Now, if I were to look at the concepts of an inductor in sum and substance, these are the concepts. Okay, so moment I take a coil and I try to increase the current in the coil, it opposes the current. The opposing current with the phenomena is consistent with Lenz law, and which results in induced EMF, and the voltage is built up, and V equal to VL equal to LX DIL by DT. So that is a Faraday's law, which leads to inductance, and inductance can be coupled inductors, mutual inductance, and when in transformer, mutual inductance is there because there is a primary coil, there is a secondary coil. So transformer application is based on mutual inductance. And then if you look at the inductance importance, it is used in AC circuits, and you look at the where in AC circuit you have a frequency coming into picture, it leads to an impedance, contributes to resonant circuit, Okay, and because resonant circuit is when the power delivered from the source to power delivered to a load is maximum when is the power delivered maximum when the impedance of the source is matched with the impedance of the load. Okay, so that is the resonant circuit, and there are a lot of applications. Inductors is more commonly used in filters, and the filters work on the principle of it is characterized by time constant, similar to time constant in a capacitor. You have a time constant with RC, you have a time constant here LC, LR. Okay, there it is, RC here, LR. Now you look at the increase in current, we can plot it with the graph and try to understand how the increase is happening with the voltage relationship, current voltage relationship, and the energy is in the form of magnetic. So this is the sum and substance of an inductor. Okay, all right. So how much voltage, induced voltage, will be produced by inductor depends on the rate of change of current. Okay, and what I want you to understand here is if the open circuit in the switch, this is an open circuit in the switch, if the open circuit in the switch is having only a small gap, okay, then there could be the induced voltage may be large enough to cause a sparking in the open circuit, and that is the principle used in spark automobile spark plugs. Okay, so an induced EMF will always oppose the motion or change which started the induced EMF in the first place. Okay, so you cannot try to flow the current in an inductor. It just likes oppose, it opposes. Okay, it does not like the change in current. Okay, so when I decrease the current, the voltage polarity will be acting as a source, and when I increase the current, the voltage polarity will be acting as a load. It is like this. Suppose there is a flux associated, magnetic flux associated with the circuit. I try to change the current in the circuit. In an increasing direction, the flux will try to increase, but the induced EMF will produce a counter flux such that it will not allow that flux change to happen. Now, let us say I reduce the current in the coil. Therefore, the flux will be changing with the coil. There will be a, because there is a current change, there will be an induced EMF. That induced EMF will now oppose this change. It will supplement, it will act as a source, it will supplement the stuff. See, a decreasing current, the induced EMF polarity will be acting as a source, which means it will try to supplement the decreased flux such that the flux is kept constant. It will not allow the flux to change. So that is, therefore, both magnet, the principle of Faraday's principle of induction, electromagnetic induction, and Lenz's law, both are playing together in and we need to understand both of them to understand the inductance or inductor for that matter. Okay, is it clear? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So when an alternating or AC voltage is applied across an inductor, the flow of current through it behaves differently to that of an applied DC voltage. The effect of sinusoidal supply produces a phase difference between the voltage and the current. Now in an AC circuit, the opposition to current flow through the coil's windings not only depends on the inductance of the coil, but also the frequency of the waveform. Okay, so if I summarize, a resistor, passive elements, resistor, capacitor, and inductor, the current voltage relationship V equal to IR. Here it will become V equal to 1 by C, I of dt plus V naught of t. Because you remember, I equal to C dV by dt. So V equal to, you integrate, you will have at t naught to, between t naught to t, you will get this relationship. Okay, so now for the inductor, it is V equal to L di by dt simply. Now you can, so current, if I talk in terms of voltage, it is, if I talk in terms of current, I equal to V by R, a simple linear relationship. Here it becomes I equal to C dv by dt, I equal to 1 by n, I of t, I naught of t, power I square R, half CV square, half LI square, series, inductor and resistor goes in the same way, capacitor goes like a resistor in parallel. So you can see that capacitors in series, whereas capacitor in parallel goes like resistor in series. Now for the DC response, voltage, it remains the same. There is no problem. This equation is holding good, the Ohm's law. It acts like an open circuit, which means it blocks the DC. Here, it is acting as a short circuit, which means the DC simply flows through a inductor without any problem. But when I try to flow a sinusoidal current, that is when the opposition is happening. Now, circuit variable that cannot change abruptly, not applicable here. There is no circuit, it is not applicable here. But here, the voltage cannot change abruptly in case of a capacitor, because if you remember the relationship between the current and the I equal to I of t equal to C dv of dt, dv by dt, okay, where v is the function of t. So if abrupt change, which means dv by dt must go to infinity, for the then the current must be infinity, which is not possible. Therefore, v cannot change in abruptly. Here, current cannot change abruptly. Is it clear? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So there are some example problems in this. I am not going through these example problems. I want you to go through these problems on your own, and the solutions are also there. You go through the problems and try to understand it, because it's part of the thing. And then I will also upload the handout. You go through the handout also. So inductors, in principle, they are used in power supplies, communication, and automotive electronic circuits. Okay, we may not come across in our course inductor. Okay, but in transformer, the mutual inductance principle is there. We will use a transformer, but this course focus is not that. The scope of this course is limited to studying the electronics, not the electrical engineering. Okay, is it clear? So commercial inductors can have inductances ranging from microhenry to tens of henry, and they are primarily distinguished by the type of core material used. Okay, in capacitors we have the ceramic capacitor, electrolytic capacitor, paper capacitor, like that. Here the core, air core, ferrite core, laminated core, so many things are there. That core decides, because the flux comes from the core, mu comes from there. Okay, is it clear? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so these are simple problems. You must go through it. Okay, so try to understand it. I'm not, because we have covered enough on the resistor, capacitors, and inductors. Okay, is it clear, man? Is it clear? Yes, sir. Dhanush?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Madhumita, is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So moment inductance come into picture,